hope the juice is still high.
Yes.
So I'll start with the favorite quote of this club. Feedback is the breakfast of champions. And if your juice is low, breakfast is awaiting you. So now I'll start with the evaluation section. So first off, we'll start with the speech evaluation. So I request Toastmaster Sean to share his evaluation.
So Toastmaster Surbhi had an excellent speech. There are certain issues I had with the speech that I'll go over just now, but I would like to point out it was an impressive speech, and I was quite happy with the way you went about it. Now, regarding something that I thought stood out to me was in the beginning the personal example that you gave and the kind smile that you had throughout the speech. It brings the audience in and attracts attention, which is essential in the introduction of the speech. It sets the stage for how the audience is going to perceive your speech until the conclusion. Regarding something I felt that could be worked on was eye contact, in the sense that though your eye contact varied throughout the audience, I felt it went too quickly. I felt you were scanning the audience and audience members. The point of eye contact is to connect with the audience, perhaps even on an individual basis, given that this is not too large an audience. But if you quickly browse through everyone, it falls flat. You don't quite connect with the audience. I felt your speech was a little disconnected from your theme. I felt that your introduction was disconnected from the body and conclusion of the speech. And moving forward, I would like you to concentrate more on making it homogenous. In the end, your humor was on point. I was quite happy with your humor. You know me, I love jokes. As I said in the beginning, humor also works really effectively to bring in the audience, to keep people's spirits high, as K. Modi likes to say. Some of your jokes were at your own expense, which also implied that you're really comfortable and confident, not only on stage, but also in the way you, what you were speaking about. Finally, I want to recommend body language. I felt you were interlocking your fingers a lot. It tends to separate you from the audience. That is my personal opinion. Also, you have a pretty large stage. May as well use it instead of just standing in one position. In the end, it was an excellent speech. I was impressed with it. The main point of this speech is to introduce yourself to the audience so we know what kind of a person you are and your life experiences, and I believe you met that requirement perfectly. I look forward to your remaining speeches here with us, and I think you're going to do an excellent job. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sean, for the good evaluation. So now I would like to call Toastmaster Chetan, who would be evaluating Toastmaster Chetan.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
Had I not told you guys that it was her first speech, could you believe that she was delivering the speech for the first time? I doubt. The moment she uttered her first words, I realized that it is going to be a power-packed performance. And I wasn't disappointed. Her voice was as lucid as it could get. And do I even have to recall you about the voice clarity? Of course not. It was bang on. Moreover, it is very rare for a member giving an icebreaker to get the command on her voice modulation straight away. She was continuously stressing on the words which she wanted us to focus upon. Some of the examples were 1.3 billion people. Do aliens really exist? And there were a myriad of examples like this which I don't remember exactly. So moving on, however, no matter how good a speech is, there will always be someone who will find fault in the speech, and unfortunately I am guilty of that. I have two recommendations for Shrejitha. Her eye contact was no doubt intact throughout the speech, but I feel she was somehow not looking at the corners. Also, I feel you must hold the eye contact for 2 to 3 seconds max. I don't want you to count 2 to 3 seconds, but I'm just giving you a rough idea. Alright. And I do know that this time you are going to conquer that as well. And coming to the second recommendation, I feel that the structure of the speech was fine, but the conclusion could have been better. The closing remark must resonate with the entire speech. Alright. However, I must say her hand gestures and stage movement was something to watch out for. In toto, her voice was clear, vocal variety was great, hand gestures and stage movement was impressive, but need to work on eye contact and conclusion. And I really want to appreciate for you for the speech. And if that's the beginning, I don't know where you will end up. And I also have one suggestion, since I have some time on hand, that which is not related to the speech. Like, it was great that you didn't use notes and neither you had any ahs or ums, but you know, try to establish a goal per speech. As in, this speech was no doubt great, but I think you must focus on the goals, like, as in this speech I accomplished these goals, in the next speech I will accomplish those goals, like the eye contact. Okay, so I wish you luck for your upcoming speeches, and I'm sure that you will give us impressive speeches like this. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Chetan, for that detailed analysis. So now I would like to call Toastmaster Sameer, who would be evaluating Toastmaster Parmeet.
Imperfectly perfect voice. When this speech started with this title, how many of you felt it was relating to human nature or human behavior? The start there itself, there was a twist. So good job on taking a title which was so intriguing, but then twisting it right over it, its head, then and there, and putting it into something as absurd as a microwave. I think he started with a microwave. Excellent, excellent. The slides that you created, I mean, it displayed human dumbness, but then that was awesome. Those slides, each one of them, were so correct example of how a terrible design can destroy things. Excellently done. And when we think of design, nobody thinks of design from a perspective of functioning of the product. We always think of it from an aesthetic standpoint. I think he took it to the functioning side of it. That was an entirely unconquered side of design. Well done. Now, how do you improve on something that had slides, that had everything, that had content? How do you improve on that? The first thing, I felt when the project title says it is research and present, and it has to be well researched. I don't know if it really counts as a research, because just touching on design and putting forward its pros and cons, I believe there had to be a little more meat into design aspect, so that we had more research associated with it. The second thing, body language. Though you have a very good, clear, open body language, but then there's a certain restricted pendulum movement that you do, and that is this. So I believe you have stage on both ends, so you can easily conquer this side as well as the other side. The third thing is vocal variety. So when you're talking about a happy thing, it has to sound happy. And when you are talking about a sad thing, for example, there was a statement, bad design costed 2 million and numerous lives. But the tone was still the same. It did not change. That sadness of losing lives, that sadness of 2 million being thrown away, did not come across. So I think we can work on that. To conclude the entire speech, I think a sincere effort was there. It was properly and amply displayed. The effort was obviously there. Along with that, it was well organized and had a very fresh perspective into the word design in itself. And to conclude, what you can work on is the body language. Let's not do this. And along with that, what you can do is maybe connect the research part a little more with the objective so that it comes across as a more detailed and a more research and associated with the project of the speech. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sameer, for that detailed evaluation. So now I would like to call Toastmaster Abhishek, who would be evaluating Toastmaster Arushi.
Good evening.
Good evening.
So Toastmaster Arushi gave us a speech on unschooling. And although she's always very comfortable on the stage, a couple of things which we can learn from her is the first, the engagement of the audience. She started with a couple of questions, but even that's not what I'm talking about. What happened after the question was she got two answers, none of them which were expected. As a speaker, learn this. Always expect the unexpected. And I commend Toastmaster Arushi to take it in a stride, answer which she did not expect from both the questions, not even once, both of them. So kudos on that. Moving on, she gave us a beautiful speech with a lot of information about what's the problems in your normal schooling, and then gave us information about what kind of other options you might have. But what she did, a couple of things she did not do right. Well, first one, the simple ones were, stop saying the word right. You do not need an acknowledgement for every statement you make. I counted at least 8 rights after I found that you were saying rights a couple of times. Stop doing that. You do not have to say right every time. No acknowledgement needed. Second, there's a very static function of how you present, and that is very similar to what Toastmaster Sameer was saying, the same thing. This motion. It's like moving that one weight transfer from one leg to the other. Very distracting. Do not do that for all of you. Do not move your weight from one leg to another. If you have to move, move the whole body to one side and then go to the other side. The third one, absolutely do not go over time. Time is something you have to keep in mind. It is very important. Don't do it. But the biggest problem is still to come. I thought I heard half the speech. Because by default, a proposal means a very simple, direct call to action. You propose something, it has to be clear. What I heard was, this is the problem, these are all the informations, now go choose. A proposal doesn't work like that. A proposal has to be, these are the problems, these are the options, I recommend this option specifically. Now make a decision, because I am proposing it. Own the idea. Own your idea, sell the idea. That is the core of putting out a proposal. If it would have been an informational speech, I would have expected it, but not as a proposal speech. Overall, a very well prepared and structured speech. It's like a problem which can be improved, and I expect much better performance the next time. Toastmaster, thank you so much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Abhishek, for that wonderful evaluation. Now I would like to call Toastmaster Nimit, who would be evaluating Toastmaster Abhu.
Some speeches get over soon, but some speeches leave a lingering effect. And today, Toastmaster Abhu delivered one such speech. He took us on a beautiful journey, narrating his experiences at his word. and then gave some very key pointers on how to fight and combat the deadly sin of office politics. What I loved about the speaker's speech are three things. Number one, the content. The content was perfectly aligned with the objective of the speech, which was to introduce new ideas and ways to change an established system, which he did. Also, I loved the way the content was started with a beautiful question thrown out to the audience and engaged the audience very well. Number two, the delivery style. The speaker's energy is contagious. His presence on stage is engaging, bubbling with energy and attention seeking. Even if you want, you cannot ignore the speaker, which is a trademark of a great speaker. Number three, the content. The speaker gave out some very good ideas on how to influence internal and external people, and that was not out of anywhere, but out of his 5 to 10 years of experience as a trainer, his knowledge base, his Toastmasters experience. He shared all of those valuable pointers. The speaker is also very intelligent, I must say. He had very beautiful analogies such as competition to cactus and motivation to self-injected energy. The speaker did demonstrate streaks of his fine brilliance, but to take that a notch up, I have a few recommendations. Number one, the content was very factual in the way that the internal and external influence points were too many listed out. So, to connect with the audience, a few things that can be incorporated are humor, few more testimonials, anecdotes, visual aids that were there on the PPT could have had a few more illustrations. You do not want to lose the attention of the audience at any point with too much facts. Point number two, the content, the speaker could have done a little more to convince people as to motivate them to combat office politics by using a few more live examples and things that the speaker himself has implemented and changed. Number three, use of empathy to gain audience support. I feel there were too many points listed out, so the speaker could not focus. So maybe reduce the number of points and bring about a little more use of empathy to get the support of the audience. Overall, to summarize, commendations, content was aligned with the objective, delivery was full of energy, and number three, information key points were very valuable. The commendations, connect needs to be made better. Number two, convince people through a little more of life examples, and number three, use of empathy to gain support. Towards the end, I must say that the speaker has power in his words, and I am waiting to hear your next speech. And to quote from the speaker's own speech, talent is only a piece of success. So please stay humble. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nimit, for that wonderful evaluation. It looks like my squad is totally killing it. Now it's time for the auxiliary evaluators. So first up, I would like to call Toastmaster Madhus. Oh, sorry. Before that, I would request everyone to vote for the best speech evaluator. So, timer, please show the red card after 30 seconds. The timer is everyone qualified?
Yes.
I request everyone to use the ballot paper and vote for the best speech evaluator. Okay, so time's up. Now it's time for the auxiliary evaluators to showcase their talent. So first up we have the R counter. So I request Toastmaster Madhusudan to read out his report.
At the outset of the meeting, I was expecting the number of, and on the basis of the number of R's and the ums, the meeting might tend towards being R-full, but it tended towards being awesome. So, but still, considering the number of R's and ums we spoke, if we had a penny or a rupee for each R and um, the dinner would be from SDTM and on SDTM at this venue itself. Coming back to my report, Toastmaster Nayan, at his initiation and commencement address, he had one R and R. Toastmaster Aditya had more than 10. Toastmaster Surbhi had exact 10. Toastmaster Shajita had 8. Toastmaster Parmeet 7. Toastmaster Sean 8. Toastmaster Chetan 9. Toastmaster Sameer, you were simply lucid. You were flawless. You had 0 hour anams. Toastmaster Priyanka, you had 7 hour anams. Toastmaster Mayank, they were multiple. Toastmaster Adamayank, you were 4. Guest Rahul and Toastmaster Farheen, you both stood at number 10. Toastmaster Hemant, you had 2 hour anams. Toastmaster Varun, 7 hour anams. Toastmaster Prashant, 4. Sergeant Anams and Grammarian, Toastmaster Laksh, was at 3. Toastmaster Arushi, again multiple hours now. Toastmaster Abu, you had 6. You started off quite great, but you caught up on the Adhanams at the latest end of his fag end of his speech. Toastmaster Abhishek, there were 3. Toastmaster Nimit, there were 5. Thank you everyone. You've been a wonderful audience. And all of you live long and prosper.
Thank you, Toastmaster Madhusudan, for that wonderful report. Now I would like to call Toastmaster Lakshay to read out his report.
So, good evening everyone.
Good evening.
What a wonderful meeting. I literally had a hard time finding any grammatical error. But here is the report. Word of the day used twice. The phrase of the day used thrice. Some wrong usage of word and sentences, like instead of use having the, we should use have. Instead of is the, we can use are the. Some wrong usage like undergraduate, and instead of use children's, it should be children. Instead of I am having 100 crore, I have 100 crore. Instead of I was dreaming, I dreamed it. Some good usage, it's quite a long list. So first of all, shattered childhood, life has been a rolling stones, thriving, introspect, sentence like still watch, focus and length, tomorrow is scary, disoriented, anguish, annoyance, implement, sentence like crafting your speech, conscious thought, and then propagating to develop perspective, Montessori's pedagogy, and such other producers like talking ill, had a heavy heart, distasteful, metaphor like competition like a shaving blade, mother of all competition, uniqueness, procrastination, remorseful, resonate, lingering effect. That's all from my side. Thank you everyone.
Thank you Toastmaster Lakshay for that wonderful report. Now I would like to call Toastmaster Nida to read out her report.
The timer, and for that I would like to thank Toastmaster Param for helping me out to conduct this role. Someone has rightly said, as we can measure time, why cannot manage it? And I'm so glad that everyone has managed it really very well. So here is the report. Toastmaster Subhi took 5 minutes 9 seconds. Toastmaster Shrijita took 6 minutes 10 seconds. Toastmaster Pami took 6 minutes 55 seconds. Toastmaster Arushi took 7 minutes 43 seconds. Toastmaster Abu took 6 minutes 4 seconds. Toastmaster Sean took 2 minutes 57 seconds. Toastmaster Chetan took 3 minutes 24 seconds. Toastmaster Sameer took 3 minutes 15 seconds. Toastmaster Abhishek took 2 minutes 54 seconds. Toastmaster Nimit took 2 minutes 56 seconds. Our president in the beginning, he took 5 minutes 50 seconds. Our journal evaluator Prashant took 1 minute 36 seconds. Our TMOD Aditya took 2 minutes 34 seconds. Timer Parmeet took 1 minute 49 seconds. Toastmaster Priyanka took 13 minutes 46 seconds. Toastmaster Madhusudan took 1 minute 49 seconds. And Grammarian Toastmaster Lakshya took 1 minute 49 seconds. Thank you.
Hello everyone, it's breakfast time.
So, my report goes as follows. The meeting started.
I seriously think you guys need breakfast. So, guys, please vote for the best auxiliary role player. Timer is. Are all the role players qualified?
Yes.
So, please show me the red card after 30 seconds. So in the meantime, I just want to highlight some good uses. So see, we have invested so much on this. So when a speaker comes here and gives his speech, use this. It would definitely help the speaker to improve. Okay, time's up. So now it's time for my report. The meeting started sharp at 6:30. I'll start with the setup of the room. As we all can see, the room is properly set up and all our trophies and our medals are clearly visible, and so is the hard work of this club. Good job, Sergeant at Arms, for setting up in this beautiful way. Sergeant at Arms stated the club mission very clearly. The housekeeping rules were brought into notice of all the members and the guests very carefully. One recommendation from my side is, whenever you start a meeting, try to start it with very high energy because you set the bar. So that is one recommendation. Apart from that, it was a wonderful job by you. So now moving on to the shining star of this club, our beloved president, who started this meeting with an inspirational opening. So he set the energy altogether on a new level. So good job on that. Reason to believe, you see a problem, then you find a solution. Good job. The guests were welcomed properly. One recommendation from my side is, whenever you call a Toastmaster of the day, introduce him properly, say two or three things about him so that he should feel welcome, because he is the host of the show. He deserves that. So, apart from this recommendation, I would say job well done, Toastmaster Nayan. Now coming to the most interesting part of this meeting, the theme. The theme was very well chosen, and the way you amalgamated the Star Trek journey with the Toastmaster journey, the idea behind this was terrific. So good job on that. Now, the recommendation from my side is, whenever you are explaining the theme and whenever you are explaining the flow of the meeting, there should be a bifurcation in that. It was very abrupt when you started the flow of the meeting, so please take care of that. And also, see, we all should be aware of the theme of the meeting, so use this whiteboard to write down the theme. I hope we are not low on budget, so you can use this marker, you can take out printouts, and it should be clearly visible to everyone in this room. The theme should be apparent to everyone. Also, when you start with the prepared speeches section, explain everyone the role of this. This is very important. So first, ask everyone that they have received. If anyone has not received, please ask the Sergeant at Arms to hand over him the ballot paper. The best part I like is when the feedback time in the 30 seconds, you were still engaging the audience with the theme. So that was very good part. So all in all, it was a very good, you played a wonderful role. Now coming to the table topic section. So one recommendation before moving to the table topic section is, whenever you call a table topic master, introduce him so that he should feel welcome. All the hosts who are invited on this stage, They should feel confident, they should feel welcoming. So please take care of that. Now coming to the table topic section, the way you started, it was bang on. The benefit, but one recommendation from my side is, whenever you start, please state the timing rules, because for the benefit of the doubt, for the benefit of the guests, it is helpful for them to know the time limit. So at least tell the time limits, and if you can tell the importance of table topic section, that would be icing on the cake. So another recommendation for the table topic section is, this is an open section for all the members and guests. So I personally feel there's no need to specifically say any member or any guest. It's just raise the hand and you can randomly pick anyone who has raised the hands. So apart from that, the topics were very easy, or everyone could relate with them. So job very well done on that part. Now coming to the speech evaluation section. I'll start with Toastmaster Sean. You did not follow CRC approach, so I think we focus more every time we ask the evaluator, we ask them to follow the CRC approach, so it helps them to bifurcate, to sink in the points, whatever points you are giving. So it helps them to note down very carefully. You were not following the CRC approach, so that could not help the speaker to sink in the thought. So please take care of that. Apart from that, your analysis was very thorough, so good job on that. Chetan followed CRC approach, but one recommendation for you is, whenever you are giving any recommendation, just showcase on the stage how it can be incorporated in the speech. Sameer, what makes your evaluation stand out is when you go deep down inside the speech without touching the elements of the speech and you give the evaluation. So that is very wonderful part. And the second good part that I like about your evaluation was, you showcase the recommendation. Like if I had to use the stage, you showcase how I can move around the stage, and so it helps the speaker to inculcate those changes in their speech. So very well done job. Now coming to Abhishek, it's always a treat to hear his evaluation. He's a very experienced Toastmaster, so wonderful job. Coming to Nimit, it was a great opening. You followed CRC approach. Just try to showcase the same recommendation for you. Whenever you are giving a recommendation, just try to showcase to the speaker how it can be incorporated into the speech. Apart from that, it was a wonderful evaluation. Now coming to our auxiliary role.